Continue reading the explanation by blasphemy philact of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Glory to Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Chapter 12, verses 32-34. Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sell that you have and give alms. Make for yourself purses which grow not old, a treasure in the heavens that faileth not, where no thief approaches, neither moth destroys. Where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Explanation. To all those who want to become his disciples, the Lord gives the name little flock, either because in this world the saints are small and insignificant on account of their voluntary poverty and lack of possessions, or because they're fewer in number than the host of the angels, who are beyond count and beyond compare more excellent than we. That the angels exceed us in numbers is clear from the Lord's parable concerning the shepherd, who rejoices more in the one which was lost and then found, than in the 99 which were not lost. The Lord showed in the parable that just as the one is to the 99, so too is the human race when compared to the angel host. Fear not, little flock, he says, meaning, do not doubt that God will provide for you, even if you take no anxious thought for yourself. Why? Because it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Since he is giving you the kingdom, how much more so will he have the things you need on earth? Therefore, have faith that if you willingly follow a life of poverty, you will not lack a provider. Sell your possessions, give alms, and thereby lay up for yourselves an unfailing treasure. Then the Lord convinces us with irrefutable arguments. Here he says, there are more which destroy, but is not so in heaven. Is it not foolish to store up treasure in a place where there is decay? But moths cannot destroy gold, and so he adds, where no thieves approach. Though gold cannot be eaten by moths, it can be stolen by thieves. Even so, not everyone suffers loss of the hands of thieves. And therefore, he adds the most invincible argument of all, for where your treasure is, there will be your heart also. There will your heart be also. Let us suppose, he says, that no moth destroys nor thief approaches. Nevertheless, does not a far worse loss occur when your heart is fastened to treasure which you have buried deep in the ground? Then the divine giving your soul is buried alive in the earth. Does this not deserve the greatest punishment? In fact, if one thinks about it, does not this very deed constitute in and of itself the greatest punishment? Where your treasure is, there will be your heart. There will your heart be also. If your treasure is buried in the earth, then your heart will be buried in the earth. If your treasure is in heaven, there on high will your heart be. Therefore, who wouldn't want to be lifted up on high rather than remain below on earth? Who would not prefer to be an angel instead of mole crawling through tunnels? Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.